This episode is brought to you by Merrill. Join one of the most iconic names in wealth management, Merrill. You'll be part of a dynamic team of advisors and specialists working hard every day to grow their clients' wealth. And with the support of best-in-class research, advanced digital tools, and the resources of a global institution, it's truly an opportunity you can be bullish about. Learn more at careers.bankofamerica.com. Copyright 2024, Bank of America Corporation.
So what's it like to buy your first cryptocurrency on Kraken? Well, let's say I'm at a food truck I've never tried before. Am I going to go all in on the loaded taco? No, sir. I'm keeping it simple, starting small. That's trading on Kraken. Pick from over 190 assets and start with the 10 bucks in your pocket. Easy. Go to Kraken.com and see what crypto can be. Not investment advice. Crypto trading involves risk of loss. Cryptocurrency services are provided to U.S. and U.S. territory customers by Payward Interactive Inc., PWI, DBA Kraken. View PWI's disclosures at kraken.com/legal/disclosures.
Hey, guys. Today, I'm going to be talking all about the AI tools that I use to scale and automate. So today's talk is going to be talking about ChatGPT. I'll talk about the various different AI applications, software tools that I use for transcription. It's Otter AI editing. It's Descript for social media and engagement. It's Opus Clip. We'll talk about live streaming. We'll talk about the pros and cons of each AI tools, as well as what I frequently use. So the first application that I use is ChatGPT, and let's start by looking at what ChatGPT is. It's the workhorse for all of your AI. It could be for automation, could be assistant. It could actually be used for the AI generation for content and creativity. It could be for assistant. It's a very versatile and powerful AI tool. What it is, it's based on a large language model advanced, which enables it to understand and generate human-like text from prompts. The prompts can be either from voice, from text, for images. And one of its strongest capabilities is it can understand context, meaning that it can build and maintain on conversations without losing track of the topic. And it can also fine-tune to specific tasks and industries. So for example, my industry is in medicine, but if you're in law or accounting or another profession, it can fine tune it based on that. Of note, there's a lot of new AI software applications that are incorporating ChatGPT into its core functionality. For example, Perplexity AI, and it's able to do various different functions and features based on the capabilities of ChatGPT. And it can understand and generate text in various languages, broadening its reach globally. And it can integrate within systems, so within APIs, making it enhanced functionality and with other platforms. So you'll see that a lot of platforms and software proliferate with this ChatGPT integration. Some of the use cases that I use ChatGPT are content creation. It can assist in writing articles. It can generate creative content, draft reports. It can also serve as an assistant. So for example, it can provide 24/7 automated chatbot responses. It can act as an assistant. Also on top of that, it can act as a creative assistant. So for example, I can put in a title or a headline, or I can talk about a particular speech topic that I'm creating, and ChatGPT can make its input and give me other creative ideas. Other functions, it can function in education and training. It can function in tutoring. A lot of advanced financial concepts that I don't quite understand that would take me forever before ChatGPT, now I can understand within minutes to an hour by answering queries and providing explanations on complex topics. A really interesting area that ChatGPT is being used is in coding and programming. So for example, my niece and nephew, they are using ChatGPT to code smartphone apps for their school projects, and they're only in their early teens, as well as a lot of Gen Z and younger millennials are using ChatGPT to code up websites, start businesses. So it's really easy to incorporate these functions and features and start companies and businesses much faster. Another use case is in language translations. when I was living abroad this past summer in Barcelona, Spain, or in Germany, I was able to take out my smartphone, take pictures of different languages, and it could translate to me what those signs meant, either, you know, everyday roads, restaurants, etc. So that's kind of the use cases. And there's a lot of things that I really like about it. It's really scaled my content creation. It's scaled, and they've been able to increase my productive output 4 to 5 times. But the thing is, you know, it's kind of a general broad. So it's sometimes its queries and responses are not accurate. And sometimes I have to go in and correct it, or sometimes it cannot understand the right context, or it's not able to provide what I'm looking for. So it's always has to be able to constantly review and double check its output. The other thing is, for example, I've been using ChatGPT and DALL-E for thumbnail generation, whereas in the past, you know, I didn't have thumbnails on my YouTube channel, but now I've been able to create thumbnails very quickly and very cheaply with ChatGPT, and it's increased my views and engagement on my YouTube channel. So if you're interested in checking out the YouTube channel, you know, be sure to follow in the comments, like, comment, share, subscribe. Really helps with the algorithm. Really appreciate it. And really, you know, this is for you. However, I would love for the YouTube channel to continue to grow. The other thing is, it's a little bit slow in some of the more advanced queries, and sometimes it'll fail. It'll spark out. There's outages as well. But overall, I'm 90% happy with ChatGPT. Let's look at the next piece of software that I use, which is Otter AI. And so I really love Otter AI because it's really great for business meetings, lectures. It can also record transcriptions in real time, or you can upload podcasts and videos from previous guests. And it has this feature where the transcripts can be, you can take out keywords, you can create headlines, you can create blog post descriptions using searchable keywords that are SEO friendly, and that will enhance your visibility within blog posts, podcasts, YouTube videos, social media, etc. And it's really, it can also integrate, it easily integrates with Zoom as well. And it can, you know, whenever you're having a meeting, it can also act as a transcription assistant. So that's been really helpful. Some things that I don't like is, you know, it can incorporate with Descript. It can incorporate with other factors. You know, it's around on the order of $100 per year, which is very affordable. And overall, it's a fairly useful tool that I use. Let's look at Descript. And what Descript is a basically I view a Descript as a comprehensive AI audio and video editor, and it's cloud-based that allows users to edit audio and video. It's really helpful. It's multifunctional. It's got a lot of AI-powered tools. It's got a green screen. You can center the speaker. You can produce the eye contact. If your eyes are moving, it can actually center the eyes. And we'll talk about some of the things that I don't really like about it. And it also automatically transcribes things. It can also overdub as well as enhance the sound. And it can remove filler words, awkward pause removal, ahs and ums, etc. So most likely this video is going to be edited with Descript. Some of the things that I don't like about Descript is that it's very slow. And so sometimes when you edit out the transcript, it takes a while for the video to catch up to it. And you know, if you have a lot of videos, it can sometimes crash and burn. But overall, the timing is quite slow. So that's the other thing. Some of the features, the new features they're coming out with, for example, the AI and the kind of the video AI software features. Those are also, like, for example, it can center the speaker's eyes, but it looks kind of buggy and it looks kind of weird, in my opinion. But they're always innovating. And if you're interested in signing up for Descript, there's my affiliate link below. Check that out as well. I really use that a lot. Descript is really great for podcasting, video production, educational content, business presentations, marketing, and generative AI capabilities. So I really use that. I know a lot of people also, Descript has its own dedicated recording studio, but it doesn't have a virtual background and it's not advanced as features such as Zoom, StreamYard. I know a lot of people use Riverside as well. But overall, I'm very happy for it. It can also, what's interesting is it can create an AI voice. So for example, I was able to upload a transcript of my voice and it was able to clone my voice. And so in the future, I plan to use this AI generated voice along with my avatar to start producing business meetings and presentations. So that was ChatGPT, Otter AI, Descript. I use all these three. Let's briefly talk about Opus Clip. And I really love Opus Clip because, I pay on the order of $100 per year, and it allows me almost 30 or 40 hours to generate short form content. And this short form content is really fabulous, especially for LinkedIn. I use it for my reels. I'm starting to use it for Twitter and Facebook, Instagram, of course, and also YouTube. So LinkedIn and YouTube are kind of where I put my podcast and grow. And it's really, I know LinkedIn is really favoring the short form video content as well. So check that out. And it's able to create viral clips of popular podcasts, popular episodes. For very cheaply. So for example, in the past I had an editor that was creating short form reels and she would charge, $30 for short form content per one piece of content. Now Otter AI can produce 20 forms of short form content from a single podcast at a fraction of a penny cost. So you'll see how much savings you can have. Very powerful. They're always innovating as well. There's different brands and templates that I love with captions. And there's a scheduler. You can also post to your socials through Opus Clip as well. So let's talk about StreamYard, which I really finding extremely useful, especially for the live streaming and broadcasting space. So what is StreamYard? It's a live streaming studio. Right now I'm recording this on live stream as well as through my iPhone camera. And think of it as a live streaming virtual TV radio broadcasting station. And I mainly use it to enhance my reach across all platforms. So for example, my workflow is I will take a podcast recording with a guest. I will upload it to Descript to clean it up. I then upload that to Opus Clip to create 20 viral short form clips, and which can then go out to YouTube Shorts and LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok as well. And then I use ChatGPT, take the transcripts from Descript, and create titles, headlines, descriptions, calls to action, and put it out. And the beautiful thing about StreamYard is I can stream it out across 5 platforms simultaneously. So you think about how fast your reach can get with these sort of AI tools. They're also experimenting with the ability to take out short form clips from each one, but I found that Opus Clip works better. It's easier to use than StreamYard. The other thing that Opus Clip can be used for is a recording studio, as well as you can conduct live on-air webinars, which I really like. Some of the things that I don't really like is that they don't have a dedicated recording room. So recently I've been playing around with StreamYard. They have rolled out with a dedicated live recording room, but the feedback that I'm getting from my clients is that they can't get into the room. So still playing around with that. I use Zoom as a backup. But that's StreamYard in a sense. You can also record it either locally. Pretty good, decent. Overall, I'm happy with StreamYard with some of those different features. I haven't really used Zoom much, but that's kind of where I am now. StreamYard's really great for webinars, workshops, live event broadcasting, podcasts, interviews. It's great for cross-platform reach, audience interaction, content repurposing. So So yeah, so this video, we talked about digital AI tools for building and scaling your brands. We talked about the different platforms, ChatGPT, Otter AI, Descript, and Livestream, as well as Opus Clip. So check that out. I'm always going to be putting out these form of videos. This is coming to you from Atlanta, from the FinCon conference. If you liked any of these videos, check out some of the links below. Check out our website. You know, follow us on all of our social media. We're really growing on YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. Check out our store if you're interested in the books that I've written. I've written 4 books, as well as our digital products, workshop courses. We have a series of webinars. Sign up for that. Sign up for our newsletter. Thank you for your time and attention. And I'll see you on the next video.